Happy Easter, Oswego, and welcome to The Real Deal, your source for spoiler-free movie reviews. I'm Brandon Macy.
I'm Connor Brennan.
And I'm Nathaniel Ahern.
Tonight, we are critiquing a supernatural action film called Hellboy, a remake of the 2004 Guillermo del Toro film Hellboy, which is loosely based off of the Dark Horse comic book series of the same name, conceived by Mike Mignola. Let's get into the Easter spirit and give our thoughts on Hellboy right after we take a look at the trailer.
Oi, I need some ID, love.
Are you serious?
They warned us that something was coming.
If there is ever an end in this forever war, it will be because of you and your strong right hand.
My bad.
I find it ballsy that Neil Marshall tried to recreate a movie by the same director as movies like Pan's Labyrinth and The Shape of Water.
Look, I don't mind that they tried to reboot it, but I don't even know what to say. I really don't.
Hellboy, greatest movie you ever saw, right?
No, it's terrible. I wanted to fall asleep so many times through that stupid movie, and I almost walked out. It would have been better if I walked out too. I would have rather been locked in the theater all night because I overslept than sit through that whole thing.
I can agree with that, actually.
All right, good. Nathaniel.
Yeah, so I haven't seen the Del Toro films, but I can tell you I probably appreciate him a lot more even without having seen him after watching this gigantic turd.
Well, he is an Academy Award winning director.
I mean, yeah, Shape of Water was my favorite movie of 2017, but like this definitely won't be my favorite movie of 2019.
God, no, I hope not. Hellboy, this movie is probably one of the worst films I've seen in a long time.
The past few years, yeah, no doubt.
Probably one of the worst of 2019. I wouldn't be surprised if this won a few Razzie Awards.
All of them.
The Razzies. Yeah.
God, what this movie and other big budget movies have proven is, like in the last few years, that is that God does not love us and Hollywood does not love us. It has never loved us. We are bait, and they are the predators, and they want to chew us up, spit us out. And that's how I feel right now.
Oh, man, that was something.
Thank you for that, Connor. Fantasy films always have to incorporate some special effects, and this movie is chock full of it, whether it's good or bad. Let's examine it at all in our review of the production design.
The makeup's good, that's it. That's it.
No.
No, you're not getting away with it that easy.
No, the makeup, for one, did not stand out. Not even David Harbour's Hellboy persona looked good.
I thought it kind of looked better than the Del Toro one, from what I've seen. That's all I'll give this move.
Actually, the Del Toro makeup looks much better, partially because, you know, the color stands out more. Red color, you know, that brings up the lighting. The lighting was dreadful. Mm-hmm. Like, it was either too grungy, too dull, or just bad all around. Like, whole scenes were just too dark. Like, characters, like, the lighting on certain characters was too dark. And it failed to make Hellboy's red color stand out in the slightest.
I'm not sure if this picture was color corrected. It didn't look color corrected.
Almost like the teaser trailers for Superman Returns, where they looked colorful, but last minute somebody changed all that, made the movie look even worse.
Mm. Yeah. Anyway, there were a lot of CGI characters in this film. I thought they did not blend in well. Oh. The CGI characters didn't blend in well.
Not at all. Like, God, I don't know, like, I mean, CG seemed to be going good for a while in its first few years of use. I mean, with Terminator 2, Jurassic Park, today?
Some of these characters tried to make these characters look really scary. They just made them look uncomfortable.
You know, like, weightless even.
Okay, so you know the scene in the beginning in, like, The Ring? When that thing happened, when they pulled up the visual effects, I started laughing. I was like, this is honestly so hilarious.
Yeah, my first impression watching that opening scene was like, I am not enjoying this.
Yeah.
I'm not going to enjoy this movie.
I didn't get that feeling right away, but I got a sort of a little bit of a bad feeling. Like, it's like I almost knew what was coming.
Yeah, me
too. There are a lot of cliches, I would say, movie followed.
Yeah, but that's something to talk about a little later.
Let's talk about, this was a very gory film.
I beg to differ, actually, because most of the gore was computer generated, and it was mostly just wanton, weightless gore, like people getting trampled by giant monsters, like all about, and it just happens casually, and it barely registers with you, because computer gore doesn't look that good anyway. Every time there is a practical gore effect, it's jarring and it has no effect on you at all. It doesn't register.
Listen, like they didn't even use computer gore in the 80s. Well, we don't need to do it now.
Well, computer-generated effects weren't that common in the 80s.
And that's why The Evil Dead looks
but
so good.
But even then, it looked better in the 80s. Gore looks better in the 80s.
This is almost as bad as The Predator, where it's an R-rated movie, but they try to cover up the fact that it's gory.
They tried to cover. Don't cover up. If you want it to be gory, just release the gore. Don't cover it up. It's R rated. It's rated R.
Or make I feel it, like it was.
Or make
though.
It look good. Like we're running. Yeah. You know what? We're running out of great makeup artists like who made gore look good. Like Tom Savini. Like if he was responsible for the gore in the original Friday the 13th and Part 4 and the original Dawn of the Dead and Day of the Dead, those all look great. And Tom Savini was a photographer during the Vietnam War, and that inspired a lot of his creations, actually, seeing the wounds in that war. But, I mean, he's a legend in the horror movie genre, but this doesn't hold up at all.
Technology has come a long way since movies like, Resident Evil and Dawn of the Dead. We can all agree upon that. That doesn't mean that you always have to use it. The gore in this movie looked terrible. I think if we use something like actual pig guts, like we've seen in films before, it would have looked so much more better.
Yeah, and the gore doesn't even serve the story. Like, especially in the final act, like, what's
doesn't.
Going on?
Sometimes it doesn't. They just do it for shock value.
Yeah.
They just do it just to have it, because, hey, it's Hellboy.
I feel disgusted.
I don't even feel disgusted because, I don't know, the gore barely registered with me. It's like, it's jarring, like when it's a good movie and the gore effects are really good. I feel disgusted, but in the way that, that the film wants me to be. But in a bad movie like this, like when the gore just looks bad, I'm not affected. But of course, you can have good gore, but still be repulsed in the wrong ways.
Well, I wasn't talking about the gore. I'm just disgusted by this whole movie.
If this was done by a college student, I'm sure this would be very impressive, but this is done by a big studio, big budget film done by professionals.
This is low. This is low even for a college student.
Yeah, a little
bit.
Wow,
Connor. When we come back, we are going to harshly criticize the writing of this picture.
Oh,
we're going to have a good time with that.
Man.
You're watching The Real Deal. We'll be right back.
To wear a uniform for service or sacrifice. Every day, ordinary Americans perform extraordinary acts of courage and selfless service. Please join us in recognizing citizen heroes who have made a difference in the lives of others through their acts of courage and selfless service in communities across America. Nominate a citizen hero today at themedalofhonor.com.
Are you thinking about buying medicine online? A search for online pharmacies yields more than 20 million results. But which ones can you trust? Medicines bought from unlicensed online pharmacies can be dangerous. You may get a fake drug, your condition may get worse, or you may experience a bad reaction. Don't put your health at risk. To learn how to find an online pharmacy that's safe and legal, visit fda.gov/besaferx. A message from the U.S. Food and Drug Administration.
Here at WTOP, we pride ourselves on delivering you all the news you need to know from the day's events.
Whether it's happened on Capitol Hill or right here in Oswego, we make sure you know all about it.
We keep you up to date on all your favorite Oswego and professional sports.
And our Storm Team 10 meteorologists will make sure that you know exactly what weather you're up against when you start your day.
Every Monday through Thursday night, make sure to tune in to Channel 10.2, because at WTOP, we don't just tell you the news.
We are
the news.
Welcome back to The Real Deal. We're critiquing Hellboy this evening, sadly. Since this movie is a remake, the writers have to make this film relatively similar to the original so it doesn't alienate fans of the 2004 version. Let's take a look at how well Andrew Cosby did in our review of the screenplay.
Oh, we're back. Oh, okay.
Yes, Andrew Cosby is the writer of this script. Now, how do you think he did?
Awful.
What do you mean?
Awful.
I mean,
is that a joke?
You have to ask. You have to ask, man.
Oh yeah, let's talk about the exposition. As soon as the movie opened, you get this terrible exposition.
Exposition. As soon as the movie starts,
it's terrible.
Then there's one action scene with Hellboy and Tijuana, and then it's just more exposition about I don't know, like. Like, there's so much exposition, I forget what each scene, like, is supposed to, like, tell us about. It's yeah. like...
And it doesn't even serve the story. They just tell you things, and it's like, okay, this doesn't matter.
They just tell you just to tell you.
No, exactly.
It's like they're trying to make up for this awful writing.
By
filling in point... Just nonsense.
But that just makes it worse, doesn't it?
It does make it worse. That's not how you write a script.
Oh, what else have these writers written? Do any of you know?
Andrew Cosby?
Yeah.
Well, there was no profile picture on his Wikipedia page, so that tells you something.
Sure, yeah. Oh, man. I watched this movie. Oh,
yeah. Okay. I noticed you're falling asleep there, Nathaniel.
No, I wouldn't say that.
Were you falling asleep during the movie?
No. And I was... What? I can't even talk. I think, like, after a certain point, like, I just got on my phone. I was like, I just want to look on this, you know, because it was just so disillusioned with it at that point. Oh, my goodness.
I was feeling really sleepy and bored during this movie.
Yeah. I also did see it in, like, the afternoon, like, so that could have been some part of it, you know.
Possibly, yeah.
So, yeah, it was a boring film. Like, you know, it was slow-paced. Like, I don't know, it felt... Like, maybe there was a half an hour too much of, you know, runtime.
I think there were 2 hours too much of runtime.
Two hours too much.
cut the entire movie.
Yeah.
They tried to throw a few jokes in there.
None of the jokes landed. Like,
they weren't funny. Like,
they weren't that original either.
There was one though that was so bad. I laughed. So like,
you laughed because it was bad.
Yeah. What was it?
It was funny.
When he came in and fought the Nazis,
Thomas Satan.
It's one thing if you laugh at a joke because it's funny. It's another thing if you laugh at a joke because it's so bad.
And
this movie was full of that.
And David Harbour, he doesn't deliver the jokes well anyway. Like, he sounds like he's half asleep when he's
Hellboy's
doing it.
None of the characters in this film were developed well.
No, like you have this soldier who has scars on his face who's just racist towards Hellboy for no reason, and they reveal his backstory, I guess, and like they were looking for the emotional depth of Quint's monologue in Jaws, but honestly, it was only like the emotional simplicity of Tom Cruise's The Mummy.
I haven't seen that one. Don't plan on it.
Don't see it. It's even worse.
It's even worse.
Yes.
Wow. How can you get worse than this? Oh, okay. Well, I have seen worse than this, but that's a different story.
I think we've all seen films worse than this at some point. But it's still really bad.
Then there's this girl that Hellboy saved years before, but she's just a token love interest, and she's nothing more than a plot device because like she can tap into the spirits of the dead, but that's all there is to her character. And Hellboy, like, like, they do this thing where they try to make him get into a moral argument about, like, monsters and humans coexisting. He feels bad about it, but it's not developed well enough, so it just turns him into a whining, complaining jerk.
He did feel very
who
whiny.
Drinks all the time.
He felt irritating, actually. Hellboy's character was irritating.
Would have been more interesting if the evil queen just took him for her groom, let's say, and they ruled the world together.
Yeah. Even then, this movie still would have sucked, but at least something would have happened.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
It's better than just nothing, you know? Anyway. After the break, we are going to talk about the performances of this unfortunate cast of actors.
Great.
Don't go away.
Josh, the stream's not working. We need you to fix it right now.
The stream's down? I'll be right there.
Oh my god, so you'll never believe what happened to Khloe Kardashian this week.
Oh my god, what happened? Tell me.
Okay, so she was at the mall, shopping at Saks.
Oh, hey, did see you there.
Hey, we're practicing for our new show, What's the Tea, starring me.
And me.
Hey, Brianna, when does it air?
Every other Sunday at 10 o'clock.
Oh yeah, I almost forgot.
Anyway, I can't wait for you to sip some tea with us.
Only on WTOP. Ooh.
Welcome back to The Real Deal. We're critiquing Hellboy tonight. You're not going to find a lot of well-known actors in this picture, but will you find a good performance from these actors?
No,
you will not. This is our review of the performances of the actors. Okay, can we talk about that giant warthog?
Well, I guess that's a good starting point.
That was such a terrible character.
I found
character.
Him to be the most annoying part of this film.
He was.
Actually, to be honest, he was the only one I found slightly funny because he was a British warthog who kept saying the F word all the time. It was funny for like a few instances, but it got old really quickly.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. I didn't mind David Harbour in this movie. I really didn't, I'll be honest. But he was annoying. Like, the character himself was annoying. But that was the script's fault, you know?
Yeah, David Harbour, he's best known for his role in Stranger Things, which is why he's not that well-known. He hasn't done stuff other than Stranger Things. At least that's not well-known.
Yeah. But he was in Brokeback Mountain, but he wasn't a major character, right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, but David Harbour, I think he was bad though. Like, I mean, other when he's not yelling all the time, he just talks like he's half asleep, and he brings no charisma to any of the jokes or like any of the dialogue.
How can you bring charisma to those jokes?
Even with bad dialogue, you can bring charisma to it. Like for my senior thesis, mm-hmm. like which is partially about Hammer films, I've watched so many Hammer films, even bad ones. Peter Cushing and Christopher Lee, two of the greatest living like talents who ever lived, mm-hmm. they always like made the most of awful material.
I don't think David Harbour is a bad actor. I just think the script gave Hellboy so many conflicting personalities that it was hard for him to give off an authentic performance.
How do we feel about Mila Jovovich as an actress, though?
This is, I don't know, I think this is the first thing I've seen her in, but I think she was bland in this, honestly. Yeah. Just another evil queen.
Yeah, she had a lot of villain stereotypes that I didn't really find like, all that appealing.
And even with a generic role like this, you can get a good performance. Like, the Tom Cruise mummy was awful, but I like Sophia Patella as Aminet in that movie.
I think she did a better job than David Harbour, to be honest.
Well, I mean, she wasn't. I mean, she wasn't boring, or she was. She had somewhat more. I don't know. Actually, I don't know if she had more charisma than him.
I don't know. It's kind of hard to tell when a lot of the performances were kind of stale.
I did not like Daniel Day Kim in this movie.
Yeah, I mean,
he was probably the worst. He was just so dull.
He was just another po-faced soldier who tries to act tough as a facade.
Like, I don't think he really served any purpose to the story.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, you have a point. Like, they have, like, this little side plot with him, but it doesn't really
matter. Yeah, but, I mean, he just wants to kill Hellboy anyway, but that doesn't matter. That's pretty abandoned later on.
We also see actors like Ian McShane and Sasha Lane in this movie as well.
Yeah, I didn't hate them.
You didn't love them either.
I didn't love any performances in this movie. It was just, they were all, if they weren't terrible, they were bland.
Yeah. I think they were trying to give a good performance, but the script really held them back. You know?
That's literally the whole thing with this movie.
But
goodness.
Like I said, you can get great performances out of bad material. Like, I mean, another example, Hugh Jackman. Like, some of the X-Men movies are terrible. X-Men Origins Wolverine. But Jackman himself is Jackman's never great. Terrible in any of them.
No. Absolutely not.
I mean, that X-Men is one thing. Hellboy isn't even that popular of a series. There's only two Hellboy films. This is making it the third one, but it's a remake. And
a reboot.
Yeah. But even then, you know, the cast here, they're not going to have that same effect as an X-Men movie.
Well, I mean, this is still like horror, like fantasy. Like, it's still fantasy, regardless.
A horror, fantasy, comedy, supernatural, superhero film. It's even confused on what genre it is. We need to take a break, but when we come back, we are going to present our final reviews and our IMDb ratings inside the void. Stay tuned.
Let's get started.
Sure. Don't ignore the law. You must call 811 at least 2 to 3 days before any digging project so you can avoid hitting our essential buried utilities. For digging projects big or small, make the call to 811.
Thank you.
Welcome back to The Real Deal. We're critiquing Hellboy this evening. Guys, I hope you got all of your anger out during this episode, but if not, now is the time to blow off the rest of your steam.
I will say the soundtrack is also awful, and they try to use it to be edgy and try to be cool, but it doesn't even fit tonally, but that's about it. God, like, that's all I wanted to say.
I am going to recycle a Roger Ebert quote. Life is precious, and the idiots who made this movie are robbing us of 2 hours of our lives to give us less than nothing. Like these people making this movie are idiots. They screwed it up. It's awful. I'd rather watch Blade 2 in 8-bit graphics. I'd rather watch Pan's Labyrinth and just have it all be puppets on strings. I'd rather watch Shape of Water in storyboard phase. I'd rather drink a bottle of Tabasco sauce.
Yeah. Connor's losing his mind. Okay. Well, the time has come, guys.
Is it?
Yes, time to give your IMDb ratings and final reviews inside the void.
Yeah, please don't see this. You'll lose your brain cells at an exponential rate after watching this. Come on, just take my word for it. I give it 2 out of 10 stars. My goodness, I need to sleep.
What else is there to say about Hellboy? It's all awful. The lighting, the gore, the performances, the story, the visual effects, the action, the dialogue. Studio executives, this movie is not worthy of getting a sequel, and if you believe it does, then you're all a bunch of idiotic, brain-dead cretins. 1 out of 10 stars.
If you're expecting to have a good time at the theater seeing Hellboy, let me save you the disappointment. You're not. I was sitting there just waiting for this disaster to be over. Hellboy was terrible, and everyone involved with this film owes Guillermo del Toro an apology. 1 star. Hellboy is officially the worst rated film in Real Deal history. Yay. Congratulations. Well, that's our show. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. Follow the show on Twitter. Have a safe and happy Easter weekend, and we will be back next Wednesday for our review of Missing Link. Are you guys looking forward to it?
I've seen it.
I'd rather see that than see Hellboy again, that's for sure.
Great.
At least it's not going to be some accidental child of a movie.
It's enjoyable.
All right. Well, that's our show. Have a good night.
Disaster tips from the objects left behind.
My home wasn't insured, but you can check your insurance policy now to make sure you're covered.
Oh.
My savings are lost, but you can put money aside and plan for unexpected disaster costs.
We're lost forever, but you can scan important documents now so they survive.
Whoa. For more tips on how to prepare, visit ready.gov.
Hi, I'm Zachary Haynes. I'm the new host and producer of the new comedy sketch show, Acting Out, a comedy sketch show by college students for college students. You can check us out here on WTOP every other Sunday this semester on B Weekends. Okay, I guess B Weekends are down here now in the bottom left corner of your screen. Anyways, we got all sorts of great sketch. Okay, guys, what's going on with the set? What's going on?
I got some oxy after I hurt my neck. First, I took them to feel better. I didn't know they'd be this addictive.